A very good morning, everyone. So here we are again with a new video on how to take the online assessment from our students. Now, in the previous videos, we learned about various content management systems like Google Classroom or LMS like Edmodo. Now, a very important question that arises in front of us in this scenario is how to assess the students. We can obviously take their presentations and there are n number of modes, but to take the test, we are here to understand a new video, which is Test Most. So let us start with it. Just type on your browser, Test Most. And this is how the screen would appear. Now, if you are a member and which is a subscribed one, you need to pay for that, then only you can sign in. Otherwise, if we want to take a simple test, we can just go to build a test. I'm just repeating again, only after the subscription you can sign in. Otherwise, just click on build a test. In the test name, you can specify what should be the name of your test. Suppose I want to take the test related to insurance because that is one topic I have taught to my students in the class. I can choose a password related to this particular test, and this password would be unique for every test. Okay, it won't happen like for the test modes, for all my tests, the password is the same. No, because we are creating a test. Now, and you need to remember this password because when the students have submitted their test and you have to see their results, it's very important to remember all these details because you need to remember the test name that you have given and you need to remember the password that you have entered. You cannot afford to forget this, remember. Just click on create test. Now, as soon as we create on test, now these are the four things. The first thing is bookmark this page and write down your password. So what we can do is we can just save this URL and we can copy it somewhere so that whenever we want to analyze the results of the students, we can simply use this URL. And as I told you in the beginning, you don't dare to forget your password. Otherwise, there would be a problem. Now, after this, we go to the next thing, which is settings. In the settings, the test name is already here and you can also see that the test name is insurance here. Okay, introduction. If you want to tell the students something related to the test, so let us write this. Let us test your understanding related to insurance. So this is something which I want to tell my students. Now, these are the four color schemes that are available to us on the free version. You can text, you can select any of these. I am selecting this blue one. Choose the language. We don't need to change this. Question settings. Now, these are the two options. Do you want to show all the questions on one page or you want to show one question per page? Now, it depends upon you. How do you want the question to happen? So, as it has been mentioned that for the new users, it is recommended that all the questions are on one page. So as we all are beginning this, so we are selecting this. Later on, when you become like really experienced or an expert in this testing, then you can select your choice. Let us go to review settings. These settings control what happens after the test is completed. So the conclusion text as to when the student has submitted his test, what would appear? So we can write congratulations. Okay. Show a custom message if the student has passed or failed. We will click this. What is the percentage score? So let us say the 40% is the percentage. Then what is the pass message? If the student has passed the test, then what should appear? Let us see, say well done. Right? And if the student fails, we can write better luck next time. Okay, so these are the messages that would appear depending upon whether the student has scored above 40% or below 40%. At the end of the test, display the users. Their score would be automatically displayed to them and they'll also get to know if their response for every question was correct or incorrect. And in case they have given a wrong answer, then their the correct answer would also be given to the students. So they know as to where they have done a mistake. And if you want, it can also display the explanation. If it is like an analytical paper, then you can also mention this. Now, access control. Who can take your test? Anyone. Now, there's a problem in this anyone. If anybody gets this URL for the test MOOCs, then anybody can take the test, whether the student belongs to your class or not. And it becomes really difficult to manage, right? So we don't want that thing to happen. And I will click on anyone who enters a passcode has to enter the password that I have told my students. So I will write something. I have entered this password. Obviously, it is visible to you right now. But otherwise, I can just tell my students that this is the password that they need to enter. Or I can select any of these options that only the pre-selected list, only they would be allowed to enter my test. So these two options are useful when the test is very critical test, like some entrance test or something. Then these two options become important. Otherwise, this would suffice our objective. Now, this section is quite important. How much time you want your students to take for this test? Let us say I want the test to be only of 10 minutes if it's the initial test. Later on, you can increase the limit. And if you want that, no, the students have unlimited time, then you can click on unlimited also. And how many times the same person can take a test? Again, unlimited is not a good option. So let us click only one time. So when anybody enters your test MOOC setting, then what do you want him to write? If you want to assess the students according to their name, or you want to assess the students according to their college roll number. So we can also do this. So as soon as I give them the URL and this password, then they would be asked for the college roll number. They have to enter that, and then only they would be allowed to give the test. Now, these browser functionality, we cannot choose this because these would be available to us only if we take the subscription. And these are quite interesting. As you can see that if a student wants to copy paste the question and want to get the answer from the Google, he won't be allowed to do that. But it is not available with me. See, as soon as I try to click any of these, this message pops up that it's only if you pay $50 per year for the membership. So we don't want to take this. Let us move forward. Do you want to receive email notification when anyone finishes this test? So this depends upon you if you want to get the email or not. Let us save this. So it will take a minute. Now the settings have been updated, and we come to the main part, which is the questions. Now, if we go to the questions, we have some very interesting formats. Let us see, these are the types of questions that we can ask our students. We have the multiple choice, choose one, okay. We have multiple choice, choose many, true, false, matching, fill in the blanks, essay, and we have ungraded and others. Let us start with multiple choice, choose one, right? So this is how it appears. Question, which is the largest life insurer, which is the largest life insurer in India? Let us give the options. LIC, GIC, Aegon, right, or Tata AI. Okay, so these are the options that I have, and I need to select the answer. Okay, so this answer won't be visible to the students, but for the marking, it's required. And then you can see this thing. So if I click on this, I have activated this. It means that for every student, the list won't be the same. Okay, so there is no chance of the copying because these options would be continuously shifting from one place to another. I can also increase or decrease the marks for the question, right? And I can also click to some explanation, but this is again not available because it is only in the subscribed version. Let us go ahead and let us go to multiple choice, choose many. So again, we have to enter the question. What are the various types of life insurance in India? Okay, so we will click on, we will write some options: whole life, ULIP, term, endowment, money back. Right, so these are the options that I have clicked. But the thing is, these all are the life insurance, so all the answers are correct. Again, this is activated, right? So if I don't want, then you can do. And obviously, the marks have to increase. Okay, and give partial credit so that for every correct answer, the partial credit would be given to the student. Let us add another important question, which is fill in the blank. Now in the questions also, you can see that there are various options of the text. You can also change that. You can just give it a try as to what are the various things that you can enter. You can insert a link here. You can have the superscript, subscript, etc. Now let us go to the fill in the blanks. Which is the sole Indian reinsurer? Okay, so I have to write a correct answer. I have to write GIC Re. Right, and I also have to provide the possible answer, like what else the students can write. So students can also write GIC reinsurance, or students can also write GIC Re. So if I select this case sensitive grading, it means that this answer and this answer would be different. I don't want that to happen, so I'm not clicking on this. I can change the marks. Okay, so in this manner, you can have various questions. You can also have matching, right? In the matching, we see in this question. Okay, so now what will happen here? With CAT, the right answer is you have to drag it. So what is the right answer? 1, 2, 3, 4. So accordingly, the student has to select. So let me keep this answer. Okay, and or I can undo this question because this is not related to my insurance wala test. Now the questions are also here. Now I go to publish. Now before publish, you can also preview or test. You can have a look as to how your test appears. So let me go to preview or test. Preview. So this is how the test would appear. Okay, so I can write GIC Re, which is the largest life insurer, and so on. And you can see that the time is coming here, 10 minutes, because we have given that particular time. Who is the largest life insurer? LIC, it has shuffled, as you can see here. And what are the various options? Let us click this. Okay, and we go to submit. But it hasn't been published yet, but still you can see that on the completion of the test, this message is coming. Congratulations, the score is also appearing. How much time the student has taken in completing the test? And because the marks is greater than the pass percentage, we have got this well done. Okay, so this is how the test would appear. Now to publish this, we will just click on publish. You can also download this test paper with answers or without answers for your reference for the future. So now it's very important to remember that this is the thing which has to be sent to your students, because by clicking on this URL and then by filling this password only, the students would be allowed to enter the test. Because until and unless they don't have this information, they won't be able to give this particular test. So this is very important information which has to be passed on to the students. Now, when the students have given the test, because none of the students has given the test yet, so let me try it from my phone and then I'll show you how the results would appear. Okay. So now let us see if a student attempts this test, how it would appear from his or her screen. So I have WhatsApped the test to myself, and the college roll number I have written as it is, and the password is ABC. I go to start the test. Okay, because I have already done this. So let me type 123 and the passcode is ABC. Start. Now let me answer these questions. The options have also again shuffled back. Okay, we have new answers. Submit, and this is how I get the score. Now let us go back to the admin and go to the results. In the results, you can see that there are two students who have answered the test, 1, 2, 3 and insurance. And this is the time that they have taken, and this is when they started and when they finished. And what do we mean by these, the 100%, 100%? It means that if we have multiple students and it is like 60% here, it means that in the first question, 60% of the students are correct. In the second question, if it is suppose 40%, it means that the second question has been attempted correctly by only 40 students. So it can also tell a student as to where we need to recapitulate, where we need to revise the concepts with the students, and which is the weak area for our students, right? And we can also export this score list to the Excel format. I hope you have enjoyed this test assessment session with the students, and you would use it in the future with your students. Till then, take care. Thank you so much.